the red corner, with a record of 2 wins, 1 loss, with 1 KO to his name. At yesterday's weigh-in, he scaled 11 stone, 7 pounds, 10 ounces, and tonight he wears the black and gold shorts. Please welcome, from Rochester, Sonny Whitey! And across the ring, in the blue corner, making his professional debut this evening, weighing in 11 stone, 10 pounds, 9 ounces, and tonight he wears the white, orange and green shorts. He's a gold medalist at the Asian Games, a silver medalist at 2 Commonwealth Games, and bronze at both the World Amateur Games and the Beijing Olympics. Please welcome, from Delhi, India, Vijendar! Is a marvelous example. He will now give final instructions to both boxers. Ladies and gentlemen, all 3 rounds.
Whiting's got a lot of noisy mates in the auditorium. He's a scaffolder by trade. Vijendar Singh, I suspect he's going to have somebody going out against him here. Who's going to have a go? Trains with Frank and Johnny Greaves, Sonny Whiting. Vijendar Singh has been working with Lee Beard since he was based over here in the UK. Living right down in the centre of Manchester, I'm told. There's talk of him going up to Didsbury, a sort of a pleasant suburb on the south side. He thought it was a bit quiet, wanted somewhere a bit more like Delhi.
Well, White is definitely going to come to a win, but Singh is technically very good. Obviously, all those medals he's won in the amateurs are just... The obvious, he's obviously a very skilled athlete, so I don't think you can give a good boxer too much room to work.
Got a bronze in Beijing, and there he beat the current WBC champion Badu Jack on the way to that.
That's the guy who,
beat George Groves, of course. Got to the Commonwealth Games final last year in Glasgow, lost to Anthony Fowler there. Cousin of Robbie Fowler.
It was a good win there for Fowler. Good right hand there from Singh. Not much power in it. I think that was the problem. His style was so made for the amateur computer scoring. Now, when the scoring sort of changed back to conventional scoring, that's why Anthony Fowler, who's obviously a massively strong middleweight, had so much success in that final in Glasgow.
And Whiting's a strong bloke as well.
I think Whiting should try and double up the jab if he can. I know it's going to be hard against Singh, but try and push Singh back.
Whiting in his 4th pro fight. His 1 defeat was against D. Mitchell.
At the moment, Whiting's just, he's turned himself in trouble. He's turned himself in the corners. He's trying to use the ring and move around. But what he's doing, he's just engineering himself in the corner, making it easier then for Singh. And even though he hasn't been hit with anything that's hurting him, but Singh's been able to pick up the shots. All good boxers, nice, like the punch from range, need a bit of space to do their work. Good uppercut there from Singh and a good right hand. And again, because he's got that space and that time to let his punches off.
Well, he's moving nicely enough and he looks nice and relaxed. You'd remember the emotions, wouldn't you, of Boyd?
Good shot.
Clipped him with the right hand, I think, and then stumbled back with more of a cuff than anything else with that left hand, the last shot of the round. It's here in the corner. Vijendar Singh with Lee Beard.
Who man knows this?
And again, Lee, suck it right in. Okay, throw the right hand, okay, to the body off the jab. Just get your distance, just a little bit too far, okay? So what, you start doubling up with the jab now, okay? okay? We start good luck with the jab, okay? Spit this one out. Just get on for it.
Up, down, huh?
That was a decent right hand.
He threw some good punches. I think Lee Beard's right. The distance is just, he's just a little bit off. So he's landing on target, but he's not punching through the target. He hasn't hurt Whiteham at all with anything, but he is outboxing him, because I just think the tactics from Sonny Whiteham, they're not quite right. He's moving around, trying to make space for his own boxing skills. I think you've got to try and push Singh back.
Well, let's see if Whiteham can do a bit more in this round, because no doubt Singh taking the first 3 minutes.
But Singh's done the right thing. He's put himself in the centre of the ring. You know, he's got all good ring generalship. He's dictated everything from that ring, that centre of the ring, and putting his punches together very nicely.
What's the biggest single difference when a lad like him comes through from a successful amateur career, moving now into the pros? What's the biggest difference he'll find?
Well, especially because he's been a product of the computer scoring, it is setting your feet. He is setting his feet quite well, but because you're so used to just scoring and moving, that you don't punch through the target. You see a lot of Eastern Europeans, when you're taught it from an early age, then it's inbred in you, because, you know, these kids have been taught just the light punches and spin off, all straight punches as well, not many body shots. So it's just getting that. So it's all it is. You've got a little bit more time than what you think. Even though it's four rounds, you've got more time. But Singh's done well. He's, you know, good patient today. He's a 29-year-old man, experienced in so many ways. Even though this is his debut, he's so experienced as an amateur.
Whiteham's fans chanting their support, but the man is not able to find the target so far. Had a very much success at all.
It's amazing how good, you know, you try and engineer a guy on with your punching for your jab and move him on the shot, but the footwork is so important. Like Singh's now, he's dictating everything just by that moving that front foot and making Whiteham go where Singh wants him to go, sticking him in the corners, and then Singh there just doing little shift of the shoulders, coming back with the hook.
Thought he threw in a low one there. Referee telling him off for getting the guy in the arm lock. Whiteham being comprehensively outboxed.
Yeah, he's trying to get his own boxing going, but it's not going to work. Singh's obviously, you know, such a good school boxer. Seeing there, good lateral movement, and using the feet as well to just turn the opponent. You've got to try and push this guy back. You've got to make it hard for Singh, I think. And even then, that might not be enough. I think that's the only way that Whiteham's going to have any success, is if he tries to push Singh back. Good time,
two good right hands and the left hook follow-up.
He still haven't got the right power yet in the punches, Singh.
That'll come, though, won't it?
I think it will come. No, obviously, you know, he haven't got a lot of time on his side regarding, you know, they'll want to put him through the ranks as quick as they possibly can. But you've got a good boxing brain. I think you'll catch on really quickly about just turning from the waist a little bit more and just punching, like I said, just punching through the target rather than just trying to hit the target. But good, it's been good from Singh. I think he's been controlled, strong in his stance.
He looks well conditioned and defensively cute as well.
Don't be sliding up here, throwing nothing. You're sliding inside there, right in the foot, touch your ribs, okay? Good work. Spit out in the bucket, okay? Spit this one out. Here. Rinse him out here. Come on. Just stay at that jab, bam, bam. Straight 1-2, okay? Straight down the middle, alright? When you come to close yourself outside of the body, okay? Also, when he's near the ropes, look your distance right, touch, stiff arm, okay? Hold him with a stiff arm, straight right over the top, okay? Nice and straight, alright? Don't try and make him too complicated, keep it simple, alright? Okay?
So we move now into the third of the four rounds in this middleweight debut of Vijendar Singh against Rochester's Sonny Whiteham.
Whiteham just landed with a 1-2. I think Singh caught him on the gloves. But it put Singh just back a bit.
Caught him with the right hand there.
He ducks his head a little bit wide in, so then I don't think he's hurt as much. He's just a little bit off balance, don't know where he is. There, then again, just ducked his head again there, and he's swinging. He's not looking at the target. That's why he's having no success. I think he wants to try and push Singh back with three straight punches and move behind the punches. Looking strong though, isn't he, Singh? And his punches are not strong at the moment, but his demeanour is strong. He looks physically strong. Oh, that's a good shot.
That's a great shot. Whiting takes it well there.
It's only an inch or two for the distance of the shot. That makes out a crunching right hand rather than just a really good shot. He's not allowing Whiting off those ropes or off out of those corners, is he? Just that front foot, just ushering Whiting where he wants him to be. Good shot as well there from Singh again. Some good skills.
Whiting trying to trade with him. Oh, that's a good one.
He felt it as well, didn't he, Singh? There, a little bit of a trouble. Whiting there, a little bit of a nod with the head.
Well, that was just pretty stupid, wasn't it? Right in front of the referee, losing a point, and rightly so. He'd been clipped by a big right hand, wanted to hold on, and then stuck the nut on him.
It wasn't heavy, but it was obvious. That's why the referee had to give a warning then. Oh, good shot here from Singh, lovely.
Oh, good shot again. It's all over. It's all over. Well, we wondered whether he could punch. He hits him hard enough there. Two or three good shots right on target. And Vijendar Singh will be very relieved, but he should also be happy.
No, John, I thought it was a good display from him. He looked really... We were saying we were worried about his punching power, about just hitting the target, not punching through the target. But he was getting confidence and stronger as the fight went on, and that last little combination was just lovely. The right hand there, really good. Referee done right there because he sort of spanned the head around there of Whiting. Same lovely distance there, lovely timing. Just that pedigree there, that great amateur pedigree he had. Really accurate with all his punches, Singh. Those ring generalship was spot on.
I thought he looked good tonight.
He was good, yeah, he looked really good, really good.
I've seen some, you know, sort of flat debuts, and you see a guy come then over here with a much vaunted reputation, and it was a banana skin ready to happen, wasn't it? But he did what he had to.
The good thing about him was his dominance in like his footwork, the way he just bossed everything from the centre of the ring, and he just made Whiting use the whole of the ring, back always on the ropes, always in the corner. It was a good display. This kid's got a good future ahead of him.
Right, here's Mark Burdis.
Ladies and gentlemen, at 2:08 of the third round, your referee has stopped the contest. He deemed Sonny Whiting was in no position to continue. The winner in the blue corner from Delhi, India, Vijendar Singh!
I thought he looked good tonight. Somebody who's going to be really interesting to see how far he can go in this sport. But first time of asking, he did everything that was asked of him, and it'll be interesting to hear what he makes of it.
Yeah, we were impressed also in the studio ringside, especially as he's had such long days as an amateur. Tommy, you know that feeling getting in the ring. We were chatting and spotted some of the...